TeleScan. Let's start with some prerequisites. The prerequisites you need to have in order to make the functionality available within your system are that you will need to install the two modules, NetSuite Supply Chain Management Mo Mobile module and the NetSuite WMS module. The first topic I'm going to talk about is WMS without bins. For that, the following setup is required. The advanced item location configuration feature should be enabled, and the bin management feature should be enabled, and the advanced bin numbered inventory management should be enabled as well. Within NetSuite 2020.2, it's now possible to receive, transfer, and pick goods inside a warehouse location without bins. So now you can manage and optimize businesses of all sizes. It could be, for example, a multi-channel retailer or a store retailer. The without bins functionality is going to provide efficiency of handling the product. For example, let's look at the picking process. So you can now do the picking without the overhead of managing bins. It allows customers to have bins in larger locations, or bins within smaller lo or yeah, no bins in smaller locations if that is required. So what is the scope of WMS without bins? And NetSuite has implemented WMS without bins across all processes within WMS, except these three processes which are bin transfer, put away, and replenishment. So these processes will not work for the without bins functionality. At this moment, these are not in scope. Let us take a look at the required setup for WMS without bins. So what is required in case of setup for WMS without bins? The first setup is to set at location level control. There are warehouse locations with the flag use bins. For this new functionality, this checkbox needs to be unticked. The WMS make warehouse site and WMS, oh, sorry, and use warehouse management checkboxes, those need to be ticked. At item level, it doesn't matter if the use bins checkbox is checked or not. With WMS without bins, there's a need to look at different stock locations within a warehouse. For this NetSuite added a new functionality, a screen in 2020.2 where you can create item stock locations and you can associate items with these stock locations. And also on your mobile device, you should be able to see the stock location. This is the new screen NetSuite introduced for WMS without bins flow. If you go to the item stock locations, it will look like this, where you have the name of this location and its associated item. And if and you can also have one of these stock locations marked as preferred location field here. The locations you see here in the dropdown, these are all locations where use bins is not marked true. It is also possible to do a CSV import for this record to get the initial data in, and also the CSV supports must data changes as well. This also allows you to set up a particular item stock location as preferred, and this preferred stock location could be your primary location with the within the warehouse where you want to stock the item. And the uniqueness here is the name. The name is unique for the item location combination. So how does it look like on your mobile device? Let's say if we took a look at this item SP wire, which is a lot controlled item, and for this item you see that there are multiple item stock locations defined. And one of these item stock locations is set as preferred item stock location. So when you go to the mobile screen, you will see show stock locations, and the preferred one will be shown always on top. So this is what it looks like doing a transaction using WMS without bins. So what is the scope of WMS without bins? WMS without bins supported inbound flows are purchase order receiving, transfer order receiving, inbound shipment receiving, returns and post item receipts. And for the inventory, that is create inventory, search inventory, cycle counting, and inventory transfer. So let's see how it works in the purchase order receiving. You will not see a difference on the mobile screens because it's controlled at the location level. The first thing that you will do on your mobile device screen is that you will select the correct location. So if the location has the use bins checkbox marked true, the flow goes into the bins flow. And in case the location hasn't have the use bins checkbox marked true, then it will go into a no bins flow. So here we'll come into the PO receiving. You select purchase order, and then you scan the purchase order or enter the item. So when you do that, on this next screen, you will see all the items within that purchase order that need to be received. If I tap on one of the items, for example, the first item, which is a standard inventory item, then you go to the enter quantity screen. And here you will show, here you will see the show stock locations, and that will show the item stock location with the preferred one on top. And as you can see here, so it's like the normal flow, but now you will not find any bin references anywhere. So once you enter the quantity here and select inventory status, in case inventory status is set, And then you also need to complete the receiving of the remaining items. And after doing that, the screen will also show that the purchase order has been successfully received, which you can see here. Then what you can do is or go back to the main menu, or you can receive the next purchase order by clicking on this button. And notice there is no bin reference because this is the WMS without bins flow for purchase order receiving. So let's see how it works for create and search inventory. So for create and search inventory, it's a similar process. You log in into the particular warehouse, you select the main menu and select create inventory. You select the item. And in case the item is a lot controlled item, you need to enter their lot number. And then you go to the enter quantity screen. On the enter quantity screen here, you will see the item stock locations with the preferred one on top again. So you enter the quantity here. And finally, as you can see, there is no bin. The system will come with a message that your inventory has been created in that particular location, as you can see here. What you can do now, you can restart the process or go back to the main menu. From the hamburger menu on the left top corner, you can select search inventory. You can tap on search inventory and you can select your item. And when you tap on the item information, then you will get this screen, which you see here, where you will see what the available quantity is for that specific item per lot, since it's a lot controlled item in that location. So in this table shown, you will notice that there is no reference with any bin. How does this process go for a inventory transfer? For the inventory transfer process, also select the warehouse for which the use bins checkbox checks mark is not marked as true, and select inventory transfer. Then you will select the from location, and then select or scan the item. Once you do that, go to the next screen. Once you do that, then you can enter the quantity that you want to move from one location to the other location. What you can see here, In this quantity of 5, also on this screen, you will see the stock locations. And then you will have to select the tool location where you want to move the inventory to. So you can see I have a couple of locations here. In this case, I'm going to select the Florida warehouse. This warehouse has the use bins marked true. So this is a bin enabled location. So if you want to transfer the inventory to that location, you will get the enter bin screen here because this warehouse is a bin enabled location. Then you have to select the bin in that particular location. And that will be the final step. Once you select the bin, the inventory quantity you entered will be moved to this Florida warehouse. But in case you did select another warehouse location and that doesn't use bins, then the screen will look like this, right? Like the second screen. If you have inventory status on, you need to select the inventory status. And then you see that you will get the final screen mentioning that the inventory transfer has completed successfully. So there is no reference of bins here since the selected warehouse location doesn't use bins. So what you did see is that inventory transfer with or without bins are supported within WMS. Let's take a look at the cycle counting process. And NetSuite has made some changes for the WMS without bins flow for this. So let's see how it works. You start by selecting the cycle count option from your mobile device. Here. Then you can, you need to select the plan. Once you select the plan, you will get an overview of a set of tasks that need to be performed. Since it's the beginning of the process, nothing has been counted yet. That is what you see here on the screen within the counted column. These items haven't been counted yet. So let's start with the first item. And when you tap on that, the first item is a standard inventory item, and during the counting process, you count the quantity of 10 for this item in that specific location. So within here, you enter the quantity, and now you will come to the next screen, which tells that the task for this item has been completed. So the count for this particular item has been completed, but you know that the user knows that there's more of this item in different area of the warehouse. And now since there are no bins, those locations could be any other location inside the warehouse. What the user can do now is you can just go to that particular area within the warehouse. And then on his mobile device, you can select the next task. And in the next screen, here you can see the first counted task, which is shown below, and the other item, which is not yet counted, on top. But in this case, he doesn't want to start with the other item. He just wants to add something to the existing item already counted. So he taps on that particular item or scans that item. So this will take him to the new screen where it is possible to add or edit the count. So here an entry is shown for the 10 quantity and the timestamp when the user entered the 10 quantity count earlier. So there are two ways here. What he could do is select the existing count by editing it. For example, in case he made some mistake. Then it will come into an edit mode, and there he could adjust the quantity. Or in some other area within the warehouse where this particular item is lying. And in that case, he can select the new entry button on the, what you can see here. If he clicks on new entry button, it takes him to the new page for the same item. And then it will take him here, yeah, he can enter the quantity that is lying in that specific area. So in this case, he counted the quantity of 25. And then he taps on the button enter quantity. And again, he will get the screen which says that the count for the 25 is done. Initially, he counted 10, and then in the second count, in a different area within the same warehouse, with the same item, he counted 25. So now we can say select plan, or you can say new task. Now, in this case, he will select new task. So now the total quantity is summed up here. Right? Initially, it was 10. And the second time, he counted for the same item 25 more, which is added in this screen. As you can see here, what you can also see here is that the counting for this first item has not started yet. Right? So in case he will select the item for which the counting already took place, he will see two different entries with two different timestamps, as you can see here. Here again, the same process continues. Either you can again edit the count by tapping on the specific timestamp, which will bring him into edit mode, and then he can change 25, or he wants to make a new entry for the same item again, which is lying somewhere else in the warehouse. I will not do that for now. I'm just going back here. That's why I select the back button. And now you will see we have a quantity of 35 here in total. And so now the other item can be selected that needs to be counted. So if I tap on that, or scan it, once he counted the item, he's entering the quantity of the second item, SP wire. This is a lot controlled item. So the correct process for cycle count now is that you have to enter the total quantity for the lots. And you have to do that first. You can do that over here. And the quantity for each lot will be specified in the next screens. So you have to enter 20 quantity in the first one. And here you can see it's divided into two lots, the 15 quantity associated with lot 9 and 1, and the quantity of 5 for this other particular lot. And now when he goes into the next screen, now it shows the total task items. So there were two items. The first item with a quantity of 35, which we counted twice, and the second item in two different lots are shown here. Now you can see the button plan complete. Because all tasks have some quantity populated, you will see this plan complete button. And once he taps on that, he will come back to the main page, which is the select plan page, and the plan which it was initially in the top is now placed below in the show completed screen. Note that this plan is still editable as long as the cycle count submitted, which is the plan that was created by the warehouse manager, as long as it is not reviewed and approved. Once this reviewed and approved by the warehouse manager, then the plan will disappear from here, and then it's marked as completed and done. So we now talked about some inbound and inventory processes. Let's take a look at the outbound processes now. So now within outbound, WMS without bins, NetSuite supports all of these processes that are single and multi-order picking for sales orders, transfer orders, picking, mark open picks, and quick ship and receive picks. And also for work orders, it's supporting the picking and assembly processes. So what has changed in terms of wave creation and pick tasks within WMS without bins? The process is similar. And still, you will create a wave for sales orders. And the only change is that you will not see any recommended bins. And the recommended bin column will be blank because of the location for which the wave is created. It doesn't have to use bin checkbox marked as true. So the wave will be generated, but the recommended bins column will be blank. Similar to that, in the pick task, also the pick task screen, know that you will not find any reference of bins or recommended bins for that particular location. So let's take a look. And let's take a look at an example of single order picking to see how it works without bins. Now you have to log into your mobile application. You select a warehouse that does not use bins. Then you select the single order picking. Then select or scan your sales order. And then you will see the available pick tasks. The picking process starts here. You can process these pick tasks one by one. Before we will start with these pick tasks, let's take a look at how we do the sorting of these pick tasks in the absence of bins. For this, NetSuite has introduced WMS sequence number, which takes care of the pick task sorting. And this is set on the item level. On the item, you now have to go to the location subtab and click on the configure link. The item location configuration screen opens. And here you can see the field WMS sequence number. So for each item, if it's configured, then the pick task sequencing for single order picking, multi order picking, and work order picking is done based on the WMS sequence number for that particular item. And this gets enabled only when you have the advanced item location configuration feature enabled. And so once you enable that feature, you should be able to go to the configure link, and then you should be able to set the WMS sequence number for a sorting pick task. So this is a new feature available from 2020.2. So how does single order picking works? You select one of the pick tasks, then you scan or select the item and enter the quantity. And you can enter the quantity and set the show stock locations. Again, with the preferred one shown at the top. And then the next page will show that the pick task is complete. So there is no go to staging button available because there are no staging bins. Then you go to the next pick task, select another pick task. So let's say I will continue with the HVAC item, which is a serial controlled item. You will need to enter all the serial numbers one by one. And then when all the pick tasks are done, you will be shown this particular screen, which shows pick tasks are complete. And from here, you can continue with the next order. So within this process, there was no bins reference anywhere. So this was it for the single order picking process. And this will end the part for WMS without bins. With the 2020.2 release, NetSuite has also introduced another key feature, which is called TeleScan. So this feature allows you to scan the same item multiple times and incrementally increase the quantity of the item for each scan. So this can be very helpful in warehouses where you work with touchless transactions and where everything is based on part scan basis. And so it allows companies to scan item barcodes, and also GS1 is supported to automatically populate data within the barcode scanner. And it definitely improves the productivity within the warehouse because there's no manual action needed since the use of a scanner, which will make it a much more reliable process. TeleScan within the 2020.2 release is only implemented for single and multi-order picking. So how does it work? Each time you scan an item, GS1 or item alias or composite barcode into the item field, which is the field where we read barcodes on the mobile device. So when you scan that item, it automatically increments the quantity by one on the mobile page. So the quantity is default to one when it starts. and it can and it gets incremented by one for each scan, because you are doing telescan. So you scan one, and then it becomes two, and then you becomes three. It continues till you meet the total remaining quantity that you want to pick. Unit of measure defaults to the transaction unit of measure if the unit of measure is not coming from the barcode. If it's coming from the barcode, then it takes a preference and it will be shown on the transaction. Telescan can be enabled for standard processes, and it can also be cloned for processes that the user creates at their end. In order to make the telescan functionality to work, some configuration needs to be done. NetSuite introduced a new system rule, which is called enable telescan, as you can see here. So within this enable telescan system rule, you will find a location and additional fields that have been added, which are quantity limit, which is a threshold quantity. So if the quantity, transaction quantity within that instance, and for example, for the picking process, is less than the threshold quantity, and then the telescan is enabled. So it's controlled if this item rule, if the system rules on based on the threshold quantity and the process that has been selected in the field, use telescan in. So that could be a standard single order picking process or multi-order process, or it could be a customized process as well. If you have a customized process defined, it will appear here in the list of values and you can select it. NetSuite has tried that this can be dependent on processes, so it can be individually configured per business process. So this is the new system rule, and based on that, telescan will be enabled if it's all set up. There's one more additional setup step that that is required, and that is the control at item level. And NetSuite has added the use telescan box, which is a flag. By default, this box is checked on all new items that are being created. For the already existing items, you can update this using the import assistant if you want, or via a mass update for all the items that you want to have available for telescan. So the control of telescan is set at two levels. First, which is the system rule, and the other control is set at the item level. So how does it work? So here we have an example of multi-order picking. You select a wave. Once you select a wave, it will show the pick task within that wave. Let's say that within that wave, it only has one pick task, and this SP wire item is a lot controlled item. So when you select this, the first thing you do is you scan the recommended bin. So this is the place where scanning the item happens, here. So that will be the first scan, and then you will go to the enter quantity screen. And what you see within this enter quantity screen is that it will always be defaulted as one, because telescan is on. So this is for the first order. The same item is required across the other orders. The first order starts and the quantity is 1 year, and within the old WMS version there was a plus icon, and at the unit of measure field, for in case you wanted to change the unit of measure, but when you enable telescan, it will not be possible to adjust the rule for quantity and unit of measure here, but you can still change the unit of measure if you want. Then you enter the lot for the first item, and once that is done, automatically the cursor will go to the field telescan item, and this is where you can scan the second item. So when you scan the second item, it will bring you to the next page. Note that the quantity has become two, automatically incremented by one. Again, the same process continues. You scan the lot for the for the second item, and then in the tally scan item field, you will scan the third item. The system will go to the enter quantity screen, and the quantity becomes 3. And since the remaining quantity is only 3, there is no other item to scan. You just have to enter the last lot number for the third item. And after that, you need to click on the enter quantity button, but the system should automatically take you to the next page, which is the second order of the pick task. So for the second order, you need again scan the item first, and the same looping continues. For the second order, the quantity will become 1, it will become 2, and it will become 3. And finally, you will get the screen, which mentions the pick task completed, as you can see here. So that is how Teliscan works. Every time it's incremented by 1. So the process is, it starts with item scan. If it's an inventory item, then there is nothing else to be scanned. The quantity will automatically be 1. And if the quantity is also on the barcode, COMPS barcode or GS1, the system will ignore that quantity because it's a tally scan and always starts with 1. And it is incremented by 1 for every next scan of the item. So once you have created this pick task, so once you have completed this pick task complete page, the process will be the same. You enter the staging bin in the bin field, since this location has bins enabled. That is why you are seeing the go to staging button here. So Teliscan works for both bins flows and WMS without bins. And then you will get the final screen that staging is completed, and you can continue with the next wave if you want. So that is how Teliscan works. Some overview for Teliscan. And the pattern we just discussed is that Teliscan always starts with the item scan. The starting quantity is always defaulted to 1. And in case it is an inventory item, just go ahead and scan the second item, and the quantity will become 2. And if there's a third item, you need to scan the third item, and the quantity will become 3. And the loop continues till you are at the end. In case it's a lot controlled item, you scan the first item, the quantity will default to 1, and then you need to scan the first item lot, and in the same screen you scan the second item. And within the next screen, the quantity becomes 2, and you scan the second item lot, and then you scan the third item, and so on, and so on. The flow for the silver items is not that much different. And you can scan the first item, then you scan the serial number that is related, and then the quantity will become 1. And then you do the same for the remaining silver items that you need to scan. So this is mainly what I want to show you about the new feature Teliscan in 20.2. There are some limitations that I want to mention. Any functionality related to customizations, since bins and without bins flow has now been embedded in the same processes, it's only changed based on the location setup, whether the location uses bins or doesn't use bins. So since it's in one process itself, if the user wants to use it for customizations, they need to clone the process. So existing customization should not break everywhere when moving to 20.2. But if you want to utilize no bins or without bins processes and customization as well, then you need to clone the process. This in order to use bins, the no bins functionality. For Teliscan, Yeah, it's recommended that you use the mobile scanner for this process. You should not manually update the quantity. If you want to do that manually, then yeah, don't use this telescan process because it can lead to errors. What we discussed earlier is that within telescan, units can be changed, but they cannot be added. The plus icon is missing on that page. So you cannot add a different unit of measure with a different quantity as it is used in the normal bins flow. But on the other hand, within this telescan process, there shouldn't be a need to change it since you are scanning the same item again and again. The closing statement here is that in order to have the discussed functionality available within your instance, you will need to install the two modules, mobile and WMS Suite app. And the note here is that you will need to install the mobile app first before installing the WMS Suite app. So in case you are already working with the mobile and WMS, you probably will need to update the current installed bundles. And it will be available from off the 2020.2 release. Yeah, this actually ends my presentation about these new features within WMS. So I want to thank you all for attending. And Marcel, maybe you can do the last.
Yep, thanks. Thanks, Jeroen. That was very nice. I think it's very cool to see that having bins implemented is no longer a hard requirement for WMS, which I think was a major drawback until now, and it provides a lot more flexibility. As I've said before in the previous webinars, we're going to post this on our site, so it will be available shortly, and you'll receive a link via follow-up email. If you have any comments, questions, suggestions, feel free to reach out to me. There's my email address, and we hope to see you next time. Thank you very much.